Kidney and Transplant Institute in Quezon City is set to close its outpatient department later this week amid a surge in COVID patients. Joining us on the line for more on the situation there is NKTI Executive Director, Dr. Rosemary Rosette Liquet. Good morning, Dr. Rosemary.
Yes, with regards to our closing of the outpatient department, both of our patients are actually on telemedicine, so they can access that. And for those who have urgent problems or need emergency care, they can also go to the emergency room. This way, we can also divert some of our nurses there to our COVID areas.
Mm-hmm. And Dr. Rosemary, can you also update us about the hospital bed utilization rate right now in NKTI?
Right now, yeah, yesterday we have 62 active cases admitted. Mm-hmm. And then today, as of this morning, we have now 77 cases in the hospital. So our emergency room, which is only supposed to house like only 30 to 40, we have 109 cases in the ER. Mm-hmm. And then 58 of these are COVID cases. Mm-hmm. And 19 inside the hospital, because we have opened another unit or ward so that we can accommodate some of the patients.
Mm-hmm. And what is the condition of those being admitted for COVID? Is it true that most are already in critical condition?
They are mostly moderate to severe. Mm-hmm. We have 4 patients in the ICU, but not really critical.
And how are your healthcare workers coping so far? Do you have enough manpower? And we've been hearing reports that health workers themselves are testing positive for COVID.
Yeah. As of yesterday, we have 34 healthcare workers who are positive. And today, if we look at the operating room, I'm right now in the operating room, we have 12 healthcare workers who are in quarantine. So it means I hope our daily operations will not be affected. And we have already asked for augmentation of the nurses, augmentation from the DOH. We're looking for more.
And what are your COVID protocols in admitting patients right now? Is it pretty much the same as before?
No. Right now, for all patients for admissions, they have to undergo swab test and chest x-ray. Before, it used to be within 5 days of validity. Now, we want to have it within 3 days validity before they are admitted or before any operation.
Mm-hmm. Dr. Rosemary, concerning medicines used to treat COVID symptoms, now, is it true that most rampant right now is tonsillitis? What of the new oral drug molnupiravir? How are your stocks doing for all these medicines?
Sorry, I didn't get the question.
Dr. Rosemary, concerning medicines used to treat COVID symptoms, how are your stocks doing, like molnupiravir, also for tonsillitis?
Tonsillitis, you said?
Yes. Is it true that that's the most rampant COVID symptom right now?
Well, it's more of a cough, and running nose, and some with already difficulty of breathing because they need oxygen. Yeah, I've heard tonsillitis, though. Well, it's more of sore throat. Yes.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And what are your observations with your COVID cases right now? How different are they as compared to the nature of cases in previous surges? Do you speculate that what's driving the surge is already the Omicron variant?
Well, I think it's spreading faster than what, especially with judging from the way we have accumulated cases in the hospital. Like yesterday, we have 32 new cases right away. And of course, with the past vacation time, Christmas time, We noted also that there were several reunion parties, this gathering, and you can observe naman the people to the malls, and they gather inside the mall without distancing, even children or babies in a stroller. They're not supposed to go up like that. We have been very relaxed, I think. Yes, I believe so.
And Dr. Rosemary, since you mentioned oxygen tanks kanina, any measures that the government is studying to address the lack of beds and equipment na rin for those na respiratory problems?
Sorry, I cannot do that. Any measure that they're doing? Yes? The question?
If the government is studying any measures to address the lack of beds po and equipment for those na respiratory cases, since sabi niyo po nagkukulang sa oxygen.
The Department of Health has always been monitoring the lack of beds and all. It's just, for example, in our case, we may lack beds. We have already networked with other hospitals of the state, so we can transfer also to other patients. There is one hospital command. It has been strengthened. And we have distributed, we have posted, but these hospitals or before any bigger hospitals, where they can go. One hospital command is one that can also look for facilities for them if they are already filed. So the government is still very active on that. One has been
Lastly, Dr. Rosemary, before we let you go, what's your overall prediction of how hospitals, generally the country, will be handling this this new surge, forecast for the next few weeks?
For the next week, maybe let's look at this like March. It will, hopefully it will go down because I believe the government and also the media should also convince the people to stay home, no? To stay home so we can stop the transmission. For every transmission, maybe we have some mutation. So if we enforce these families to control their family members to go up necessarily a lockdown, total lockdown, it will be very for our economy. But they have also to know where they are going and not to congregate in any sense or to have parties again. I will stop this one.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay, we continue. Right, we continue hoping for the best. Thank you so much, Paul, for joining us this morning, Dr. Rosemary. You stay safe.
Thank you very much, Edmond.